Hi there. Welcome to my video series on how to grow your own sorghum fodder at home like an expert. Yeah. Why do we need to grow hydroponic fodder? Number one and the most important is that it lowers feeding costs by up to 50%. Feeding costs, be it for chicken, be it for pigs, for dairy cows, for goats, for sheep, for rabbits. It reduces feeding costs by up to 50%. It can even go higher. Okay? Then number two, it increases the productivity of animals by up to 25%. What do you need in order to grow your own hydroponic fodder at home? The seeds. Seeds like this one. This is sorghum. These are the seeds that you need. You remember you said hydroponic fodder is growing animal feed. We are using seeds without soil and with little water. You need incubation containers. An incubation container. I have one here. This one, I use this one. This is plastic, is the best. You make sure that you have a container that is translucent. Translucent means it passes light. It passes light. So it can be light here or it can be light in the container. This can be a different color, and then as long as there's light getting inside. And plastic is the best, because it helps to preserve moisture. It is plastic containers are airtight. They help to preserve the moisture. You need trays or containers to grow the fodder on. So this is just a homemade one, and I just decided to add PVC to cover it up so that the seeds, you see, it has, the holes are a bit big. Here it is raised. Also on this other side. Then here this PVC is flat, completely flat, so that when there's excess water, we'll teach you excess water, the excess water is able to drain. Then we have this other one that you go to the blacksmith to make, this one here. So this one, it's made from zinc. You cut seeds for 1 kilogram, it can support weight up to 13 kilograms. So this one is made for zinc. Remember, zinc is very good for feet as compared to aluminium. Don't go and get aluminium trays. Don't go and have aluminium trays made for you. Get zinc. Zinc is the one that is human friendly. Remember, these feet are being taken by animals. Then animals, those products will be consumed by human beings. Then the other thing that you need is sodium hypochlorite. Sodium, this is jig here. I'm not marketing jig, but you know, it's sodium hypochlorite here. So this one, you need it to sterilize the seeds, especially because we'll be using water and they'll be taking some time to grow. Sometimes there's the growth of molds. And when you put this, we sterilize the seeds before we start sprouting them. Those spores or those organisms, they get destroyed. Plus other bacteria and viruses that can bring can start having growth. What is the procedure for growing sorghum hydroponic fodder? So number one, you need to wash the seeds in clean water. Me, I've washed them. These ones, they are clean. And you just wash them once, then whatever you find on top of water, you know, you find some things that are floating, all that you remove, okay? Then after that, you just need to wash one sorghum. Two, you soak the seeds in water containing hypochlorite solution. Hypochlorite solution, the one I told you, jik here. For purposes of this video, already I had soaked in this hypochlorite solution. For 20 minutes, and the ratio of mixing the hypochlorite solution with water is 1 milliliter as to 1 liter of water, and then you soak for 20 minutes. So I have ready, for purposes of this video, I have already done it. So this one I have already washed and I've already soaked in hypochlorite solution for 20 minutes. So number three, you drain and clean once. So I've drained and I've cleaned once. Then soak seeds in water for 4 hours. This is my water, almost approximately 1 liter of water. And we are going to soak our seeds here. So we are going to soak for 4 hours. Then after 4 hours, we are going to drain. So make sure you subscribe to my channel so that you do not miss any videos. And thank you. See you guys after 4 hours. Then we continue from there.